Welcome to Second Sec, the show that focuses on the issues behind the news. Mining Weekly editor Martin Creamer joins me today to unpack the latest in the mining industry. Welcome, Martin.
Thanks, Ashley.
So let's start off with Royal Bafokeng Platinum. They have a 1.6 billion 98 megawatt solar power plant.
So you can see what the mining companies are doing. You know, mining was also part of a minerals and energy complex. We always say minerals and energy together. But energy fell down a bit because of all sorts of issues around Eskom. Now they've got this excitement of doing it for themselves, but not only doing it much more economically, but sometimes even off balance sheet. So they don't have to put out 1 cent. They just have to agree to buy the electricity, and they buy it at a much lower price to what they were paying for Eskom. And then the big bonus is decarbonisation at the end of that. So you see Royal Bafokeng Platinum, you know, working on this now to go onto their own generation, and that'll just grow. That'll grow and grow as things develop. We also see the ferrochrome people saying what a wonderful new era the president has brought in, because it can enable them to think much bigger now. They haven't got a restriction of 100 megawatts. They can go large. And when we look at the smelters they got, they've got to go into thousands of megawatts. So it's just a question of on-site. Normally you get solar. Off-site, you can get wind. You can buy in at a cheaper price than you're paying now. So it's just an enormous win, because it also records on their decarbonization credits. So a massive new era.
And Barrick is seeing the benefits of renewables at its Mali operation and at its Kibali gold mine.
Yeah, so you know, Barrick is deeply in Africa. It's in the Democratic Republic of Congo, it's in Mali, it's in Tanzania, it's looking at Senegal, where things are really going well. And in the Democratic Republic of Congo, it's in a situation where it's protected from these new energy prices. It's protected from the high diesel price because they've got their own hydropower plants. So that they're already green, you know, in DRC, which you can see these miners absolutely, if they've gone green now, they're so happy, and it's normally at a lower cost, and there's energy security. In Mali, however, they're heavily dependent on diesel. So now they're trebling their solar. You can see the same trend, you know, on-site solar, it's hot, Africa sun, you can do it. You can do it at an economic price. So more momentum towards not only decarbonization, of course they all have to do that as well, but they're getting energy security. They don't rely on importation of things like diesel, so they're getting their own independence, and this is really exciting them.
Lastly, as government focuses on decarbonisation, the renewables momentum is gaining traction with wind, sun and water energy sources.
You know, we're sitting here having to import oil and import petrol and import diesel. It is always a strain on our economy. Here we've got the opportunity for energy freedom, you know, for energy sovereignty. And when it comes from the sun and the wind and the water, I mean, it's just compelling. But then the plus is also decarbonization. So you can see where we are positioned very well here, because we have been working with this sort of hydrogen link as well. So it's very well known to Sasol, for instance, you know, what hydrogen is all about. All they've got to do, of course, is move from the grey hydrogen to the green hydrogen. Already they're starting to do that. Already they're starting to put up the unrenewable energy situation, and they were possibly leaders. I mean, it goes far back with the renewable energy. They knew that was possible and generating their own electricity. But it's just a position we're in now, you know, where we've got superior sun, we've got prime wind, you've got land, you've got the metals and minerals, you've got the expertise. You know, there is just nothing that we haven't got in this situation, which puts us ahead. And we need to accelerate this. We see it is being accelerated now under the new energy scheme. They're realizing how well positioned we are. And hopefully that will really move into implementation phase very, very fast, because the feasibility studies have been at an advanced stage now.
Thanks for speaking with us, Martin.
It's a great pleasure, Sashni.
That's it for today. Join us again next week for more news analysis on the local and global mining industries. To subscribe to Creamer Media's Engineering News and Mining Weekly, please email subscriptions at creamermedia.co.za.